Okay, we are going to review some of the things that we learned before spring break. So we're going to be talking about linear equations. We're going to start with a general formula. What's our general formula for a linear equation?
Y equals mx plus b.
Did it work?
No.
Your lights just went off. You should be good.
There we go. Y equals mx plus b. Excellent. So my first question to you, for you to write on your whiteboard, is what does m stand for? What does m stand for?
Isn't it the slope,
right? The slope. Shh.
See.
What does m stand for?
Mandy.
All right, hold that up in 3, 2, 1. Excellent. Everyone said that M stands for slope. My second question to you, what do you think I'm going to ask next? What does B stand for? Write that on your board. What does the B stand for? But our spelling of this has gotten a lot better as well.
It don't come until this.
All right, we're going to hold that up.
I'm not playing.
In 3, 2, 1.
Y-intercept.
Excellent. Y-intercept. What sport do we like to think of when we think of intercept?
Basketball.
Football. Interception. So it's interception without the I-O-N. All right, very good. So that's our general formula. Now let's put some numbers into it. If we had 3/4 x, let's do minus 5. My first question to you, if that was the formula of my linear equation, that was my equation, what is the slope of that line? What is the slope of that line? Equation. All right, hold that up in 3, 2, Everybody understand why that's a negative? If it's minus, it's a negative for our y-intercept. What does our y-intercept mean? What does this coordinate point tell us?
Where it crosses the y-axis.
Where it crosses the y-axis. Perfect. All right. Let's try. This time you're going to be writing the equations. I'm going to tell you some information. You're going to write an equation for me. So let's say our slope was 4. And our y-intercept, I'm just going to do y-intercept.
We don't need this.
Is 0, negative 2. So you need to write an equation using that information. You need to write an equation using that information.
All right.
What should our equation always start with?
Y.
Y equals.
Is it like this?
Where did
job. All right, so we have y equals. When I filled this in, I got 3 minus 2 on top. And I got x2 minus x1, so 2 minus 0 on bottom. So that is 1 half. So y equals 1 half x. How did you know, how did you guys all know that the 2 was my y-intercept?
It starts with a zero,
but your x is zero, so plus 2.
I can do it myself.
All right. Elijah and Blake want to do one with 30 in it.
No, I'm 100. Yeah. I want to do 150. I don't know about Blake.
No. So let's try. If we had, let's just do 1 comma 2. Let's do 1 comma 2. And
15
and
30.
We'll do 30 over here. And we'll do 6 over here.
What?
Tell me if you need more information.
It's time. So it's 5 times 6, 30.
Perfect. Cam had a great question. Cam, can you repeat your question?
How do we know which one's the y-intercept?
Do we know that?
No.
Good question, Cam.
We don't. So let's solve for our slope for this one. Solve for our slope. So we have x1, y1, x2, y2.
It's not just 6:30. It's not 6:30. It's 630.
I had 630.
You can't even do it. What are you telling me to do?
I don't know.
All right.
So and what'd you get?
I got the answer.
All right, hold it up. Everybody hold yours up.
All right.
This one was tricky.
I didn't do it yet.
I don't feel well.
Hey, most people got it. Good job. We had 30 minus 2. And we had 6 minus 1. That would give us 28 fifths.
Dang it.
So normally we would try and simplify, right?
Can you do 150?
That's not a nice one to simplify, so we can just leave it like that.
Can you do 150?
Not yet. I think that was a good challenge. Thank you, Elijah. All right, last couple ones. We're going to sketch this time. So I'm going to give you an equation. You're going to sketch it out. What does a sketch look like? A drawing. It's a picture. So draw a nice big coordinate plane on your whiteboard.
Curly back.
And we are going to sketch y equals x minus 3. So think about what you're, where you're going to start. Where should you start when you sketch?
Origin?
We're not always going to start at the origin.
There's no
number. It's from the y-axis, so our y-intercept, right? What is our y-intercept here? Negative 3. So we're going to start by plotting 0, negative 3. What's our slope?
1.
So from this point, we're going to go up 1 over 1. And that'll give us 2 points, and that's all we need to make a sketch. It helps to make little notches on your axes so that you have a nice even scale. This is what I mean by that. It doesn't have to be perfect. That's really not perfect, but just a sketch. So 0, negative 3 would be 1, 2, 3. That's my y-intercept. And then we're going to go up 1, over 1. Up 1, over 1. Up 1, over 1. You really only need 2 points to make a line, but the more you make, the more accurate your line is going to be. Then we draw a line straight through that. And there's our sketch. So once you have your sketch and it matches mine, hold it up. So I can see them all. Beautiful. Excellent. All right, we're going to do the same thing. So you're going to start with your Y.